Doing the Reyes home was very fun. As a wonderful expression, I think, of what it is to grow up in a Latino home. The Reyes house is really like the heart of the film. There's so many little things in there that are so authentic.
In the early 80s, my grandma, she had all these things in the house.
I was able to go back and think about growing up. Oftentimes in Hispanic culture, you need places to put things, but you don't have a curio set or cabinets or something. So oftentimes they'll just start cutting into the walls, and then they'll use the 2x4s to help frame the walls to put some shelves in, and then voila, you've got a shelf unit. And visiting my grandparents and my abuelas, they had the Virgen de Guadalupe. That's not just a picture, it's like a shrine. So I was able to bring a lot of these things in that surrounded me in my youth.
Blue Beetle, it's a movie that centers around a Mexican-American character in an unabashedly Latin American movie. That's what makes it different. It's every detail. It's in every fiber, in every shot, in every character, in every costume, and in the people making it.
I never been in a movie who talk about Latin people as this movie. I help put the values of Latin and Mexican people, not only that, for a good people, for the minority.
We're often shown as gangsters or narcos. It's never so much about our values and what makes us special.
It's such an important thing to see yourself represented on screen, behind the camera as well. You know, someone who looks like you, someone whose family kind of is like your family, sounds like your family, eats the same food as your family. Seeing that portrayed in a positive light is so immense and so powerful.
To see people like me with hopes and dreams, with a loving family that cares, and eventually becoming superheroes of our own story, it's very special. Nobody can tell our stories better than ourselves.
I mean, just the idea to begin with, and I have to speak as a Latina. Ángel Manuel está haciendo una historia y una revolución en la cinematografía. Una revolución verdadera en todos los sentidos. En la forma como está dirigiendo, en la historia que está haciendo, en el grupo de gente que estamos aquí juntos, y el tipo de historia.
You know, is it always the right time? No. Was there a better time? Maybe. But the time's now. So the Blue Beetle is, it's pretty amazing.
I think that Blue Beetle sounds like it's electrifying and it's exciting and it's big and it's bold, but at the core of it is a big beating heart full of emotion. Angel had a very specific vision for this film, and I think that we work really well because you communicate emotionally, and you know, yeah. I think we're both very empathetic people. And so when it got to actually working, you know, it's just really fun journey of getting to the emotions.
There is expectations, but how can we take those expectations and translate it into a language that resonated with what we wanted to create, a little bit more of like this VHS 80s nostalgia, Tangerine Dream-esque, you know, vaporwave aesthetic. Like, we just kept throwing like different type of like things of like, our mood board is very complex.
Some of it's kind of techno, you know, like there's a little like pulling from like dance music and electronic music kind of production techniques. And then, you know, there's very traditional orchestra stuff on top. But even with where we're going quite traditional with the orchestra, I try and throw something in, you know, to detune everything or to have it in different registers that you don't normally get these kind of scores. You know, there's a ton of modular synths and custom kind of vaporwave-esque, big glassy synths.
We kept sending back and forth like different music, just like, oh, like just listen to this, like close your eyes, like what you're feeling. This feels like what I wanted to do, you know, and that's not talking about instruments or anything, it's just about that emotional journey.
We talked about like Demon Jimmy Page.
Yeah.
And, like, you know,
like channeling your Jimmy Page.
the main theme for Jaime was really exciting. You know, Angel and I spent a good deal of time talking about Jaime and his journey and the family and what that means. You know, I had a very kind of subtle string and drum thing going, and then on top of that, you just have this banana. It's like a, and it's a big synth that I made, and I put it through like five different distortion pedals to make it huge. You almost want to feel like it's bursting out of him.
Being part of something like this is just like, oh, wait, what I thought I was being surprised enough with the whole process, this is like another level.
It's such a rich world and the characters are so well developed that I'm like a kid in a sweet shop. You know, that's really magic.
You know it's gonna be a good score when the subs are coming through. We just feel like...
Let's roll, please. Rolling.
Action.
This is what we call the cosmic realm. After Jaime is captured, he flatlines. He falls into this coma. He goes through this construct in his brain that has this mix of home nostalgia and cosmic elements.
What's going on?
Hey, todo va a estar bien.
This is where he realizes what he needs to hear in order to become a superhero, to take that final leap of faith and become one with the Scarab.
I'm so proud of you. This is your purpose.
His father says, you're gonna get through this, and we're all gonna get through this because we're strong. Damian was such a generous scene partner. Really, the whole movie isn't possible without Damian, without the father.
This is a very special moment. It incorporates Latin American mysticism, but also hope and that guidance that we get from our ancestors.
I need you, Kaji!
Most superhero movies are one person doing everything to save the whole world. The essence of this movie is to really show that it's not possible. All the moments that led up to Jaime even encountering the Scarab were because of the foundation that his family was able to build on. And I hope it'll make a lot of people realize, like, it's okay to not do it alone.
There's so many favorite moments, but definitely this one is one of the most emotional.
Go, go, go!
Okay.
Ready and now!
Okay, let's go! Yeah.
The cosmic plane sequence, it's probably one of my favorite of the whole movie.
All right, Kaji, come on, let's go! Activate!
Freeze! Don't move!
But seconds after that moment, Jaime has to get it together. And he does.
Ready, Kaji?
Vamos a partirles la madre.
The third act starts with Milagro pinned down by 10 Black Ops, and then Blue Beetle shows up behind. This is what they call the old boy sequence because he just mows down through the guys. I think we had 33 wire gags all in one fight.
What the hell? Thanks, Kaji.
De nada.
Watch out!
OMAC incoming, Jaime.
Action!
I want to hit you again.
Yeah. So, this is kind of the tail end. This is what I look like right now. It all feels very helpless. This is definitely the lowest point of Jaime's journey.
You know, at the end of the movie, we see that Jaime is ready to shed some blood.
Jaime thinks Carpax killed Rudy. In a lapse of rage, Jaime loses control and starts beating Carpax to the pulp.
Any more? Baker?
That energy is the one that almost makes Jaime step to the dark side.
And 3, 2, 1, go!
Jaime, you're losing control.
At the beginning of the movie, Kaji's instinct is always to solve problems by eliminating them.
Eliminating threat.
Stop! I'm not a killer!
Jaime's instinct starts out very clearly, like, no killing. By the end, he's angry, like any of us would be. But Kaji actually steps in, having learned from Jaime.
Kaji is really able to say, like, yo, that's not us.
We're not killers, Jaime.
You have this power, but you gotta stay true to who you are, too.
For me, that was very special because Jaime had all the right to feel this way. But what does that say about our hero? That compassion is what sets him apart.
That's what makes me strong.
The thing that really brings it all together is knowing that Angel, Garrett, all of the people in our movie, behind the cameras, are all here for the same thing. And that instills so much confidence in me.
Come on, that's all you got it
for. Being a DC Universe writer is something that the 11-year-old me in Querétaro would have never believed. To me, it's a really incredible privilege. Jaime Reyes is the future.
Yes, he's a superhero, but everything around him, it's just so human and alive and so powerful.
In the end, the superpower is love and the family. We need to see families that fight together for their survival.
Hundreds and hundreds of people on this film each brought their unique visions and their passion for this character that made it what it is. And to me, that's what I'm the most proud of.
Knowing that Jaime exists and kids like me can actually aspire and dress up to and finally have a costume they can embrace and cheer for, it's one of those things that is very exciting.
I'm super grateful for it.
And this is just, you know, hopefully the beginning of a bunch of other characters to come out of Banmara City. Who knows? They don't tell me.
Thank you so much!
Yes! Love it.
Boom, fist bump, boom.
There we go, thank you, bud.